मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माई चैनल बोन डॉक्टर। आई एम डॉक्टर प्रसन्नजीत दत्त। आई एम अ फुल टाइम ऑर्थोपेडिक सर्जन एंड अ पार्ट टाइम यूट्यूबर। इन माई प्रीवियस टू वीडियोज आई वॉज टॉकिंग अबाउट सर्वाइकल स्पॉन्डिलाइटिस, हाउ इट डेवलप्स एंड हु आर द पर्सन्स हु आर प्रीडिस्पोज टू सर्वाइकल स्पॉन्डिलाइटिस। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट स्टेजेस ऑफ सर्वाइकल स्पॉन्डिलाइटिस, in how many stages cervical spondylitis develops and what are its symptoms. The first stage is the stage of neck pain. In this stage, the patient experiences stiffness and heaviness in the neck. There may be occasional pains, stages of pain-free periods and stages of painful periods. Pain may increase after getting up from sleep and it decreases with activity, and pain may be increased while the patient is sleeping. This is a typical stage of stage 1 of cervical spondylitis. This happens due to slow degeneration of the facet joints. The facet joints are the joints inside the cervical spine through which the nerves pass. Due to slow degeneration and damage to the facet joints and the cervical disc, which lies between the two vertebrae, the cervical spine movements are not smooth enough and thus it becomes painful. Occasionally, patient may feel sounds in their neck. These are the symptoms of stage 1 of cervical spondylitis. Coming to stage 2, there is a stage of cervical radiculopathy. In this stage, due to excess hypertrophy of the facet joints and the ligaments of the cervical spine, the nerves which comes out from the cervical spine gets entrapped. Due to entrapment of the nerves, the signal transmission through the nerves is not possible. The nerves experiences pain, and the patient experiences pain in the hands, in the shoulder, in the elbow. There may be radiation of the pain to the head, that means the patient may feel headache, and occasionally there may be vertigo. This is the stage of cervical radiculopathy where the nerves are involved in addition to the joints of the cervical spine. And then coming to the last stage, that is the stage of cervical myelopathy. In this stage, the spinal cord which passes through the spinal canal is also involved, is also compressed due to excess cervical spondylitis, and the nerves are also badly damaged. Thus, there is complete stoppage of signal transmission through the spinal cord. So the patient may experience complete numbness or absence of sensation of the hands and foot. There may be problem in urinating, defecating, and there may be complete paralysis of the hands and legs. This is the most severe stage of the cervical spondylitis. So we should be aware of the cervical spondylitis stages and in which stage we are suffering, if we at all suffer from cervical spondylitis, so that we may not neglect it and we may not land up in cervical myelopathy. So these are the three stages. Hope you like the video. Give a like if you liked it. And do subscribe to my channel for such videos. In my next video and the last video about cervical spondylitis, I would like to discuss about the treatment which you can do at home in these three stages of cervical spondylitis. So do tune in to my channel to learn such topics in future. So bye bye for now. Thank you.